27 minutes past seven, Jordan has said it's prepared to hand over an imprisoned female Iraqi jihadist who's on death row to Islamic State fighters if they release a captured Jordanian fighter pilot. The group threatened to kill the pilot and a Japanese journalist within 24 hours unless the woman was freed. Well, Davis Lewin is Deputy Director and Head of Research at the Henry Jackson Society, a foreign and defence policy think tank in London. Davis, a very good morning to you.
Good morning.
First of all, there was a demand for $200 million for the Japanese gentleman. Now it's an exchange of prisoners, if you like.
Well, indeed, it does seem, and it is, of course, a fast-moving story, some of the details in which aren't clear. I think we are unclear, even at this stage, according to some reports, about whether the Jordanian authorities, who have now made what I consider to be a regrettable offer to enter into this exchange with Islamic State, whether they actually know that the pilot is still alive. It appears that the latest reports still say that Islamic State has not given them these assurances in that way. But the broader point here is that it is very gravely dangerous to enter into these kinds of agreements with terrorist entities such as Islamic State, because what it does is, in some ways, you and I talking about it is already a form of victory for Islamic State by way of getting this story pushed up into the media agenda and getting the audiences, be it in Japan or in Jordan in this case, or of course in the United Kingdom when it comes to our hostages, to have this kind of emotional reaction that they want to this. It is unfortunate. It is devastating, of course, to the families of these people who are directly involved in what is a very grave war. But it has to be understood that in the overall strategic picture, paying ransoms to these kinds of terrorists encourages them to go ahead with these kinds of operations, encourages them in some cases, if the ransom is financial, it of course fuels their war machine if they were to have gotten, in this case, it was $100 million ahead.
What can you tell us, Davis, about Sajida al-Rishawi, the Iraqi jihadist whose release is demanded?
Well, this is a woman who is in a Jordanian prison on account of being part of a suicide mission in Jordan, in which her belt didn't go off. The other suicide bomber's belt did go off. About 60 people killed. And afterwards, she had been arrested on account of the fact that, as I say, that her suicide belt failed. An al-Qaeda operative in a Jordanian prison. The strategy that Islamic State have employed here is very clear. Initially, they are obviously themselves changing this all the time, how they approach this. Initially having asked for money and realized that that wasn't going to happen, they then switched to seeing if they could free this terrorist from Jordanian cell in that way. And the Jordanians must have been under some pressure from the same kinds of arguments that I've just made about, not negotiating with terrorism as so as to not encourage it. But it seems that they are now willing to, or at least have indicated that they are willing to exchange it, despite, as I say, not even having the assurances yet whether the pilot is alive.
Okay.
And it is also the case that they have made quite clear that they would not give the this terrorist that is in their jail freedom in return for the Japanese hostage only.
Okay, Davis Lewin.
Something notable as well in that way.
Yeah, we'll leave it there. Davis Lewin from the Henry Jackson Society. Thank you.